He's a part-time player. He God split time with Jared Kelly.
Hey, stop screaming at your wife. I know you guys got a new house going through it. All right, let's
go. I'm loading the pod. Damn it.
Chase didn't got no time for this anyways.
Cup to cup.
Yeah.
Your favorite
is your favorite person of all time. My name's Kevin, and I host the Cup to Cup podcast. This is episode number 252.
Are we just going to let him do this? What are we doing?
If he's doing it,
just,
he better do it the whole time.
Just roll with it.
I'm done. That's it. That's okay, all you do. Welcome in, everybody. It's Cup to Cup podcast, and episode 252. Thank you for joining us. We got a very excellent episode. Once again, like I said last week, we kicked Jason off the podcast, so he's gone. He's gone forever.
Out.
Later.
We weren't kidding. He's literally gone.
It was fun. Yeah. We're going to miss the newsboy hat and everything. But
nice, Kev.
You're welcome. You know, we're going to miss, you know, his six-packs of abs that he's known for on all cruises. We're going to miss his...
Baby blues.
His baby blues, his neck vein, Harriet. We're going to miss Harriet.
Harriet for sure.
A lot of people don't know about that, but we're going to miss Harriet.
Well, ask him. If you ever want to know what Harriet is, just send him a direct message and be like, hey, tell me about Harriet.
No, send me a picture of Harriet. Yeah. But anyways, my name's Kevin. If you haven't listened to the podcast yet, welcome in. Thank you for joining us. We are an amazing podcast. We do segments, all right? We do these crazy segments, kind of like a game show, but we do it with friends. And my friends are all here, except for Jason, who I mentioned. Chase is here. He has lost his voice.
So
doing a podcast without a voice. That's going to be...
That's tough. Feel like that was a voice.
Okay. We also have Chris here. I like to get a mid-sip. He just finished.
You do, that's your thing. What's up, boys?
Promise me he's going to talk into his microphone this week.
I realize I fumbled the opening last week. I'm going to be better. I'm bringing better.
Okay.
Hey, dudes.
Dustin. That was a fuck-up.
So, yeah. And we also have the freshly tuned-up hair, beard, eyebrows, everything for $49.99 here in Orlando, Florida. Jose Carvalho.
That is including the tip. What's going on, Pod Poppy?
Poppy.
I changed my name on here, Pod Poppy, because we were talking
about
that.
He's the Pod Poppy.
Yeah. Until I get dethroned.
Now that Jason's gone, you are officially the Pod Poppy.
You know, I'm just happy to be here, you know.
He loves that title. He loves it.
He does. He does.
I'm going to embrace it. Somebody's got to carry the load while he's gone, you know. So
yeah, you do.
We do miss him though, and you know, once you're done with your corporate things, hey team,
hey, I want to check in, guys.
Guys, we're a team. All right, let's all make sure that we're having each other's backs here. All right, bros.
Hey team. Team, while I'm gone, team, if you guys could just take care of these few things.
Chase, will you do me a favor? Can you turn your camera off? And then, Kevin, I want you to do the team voice.
Yeah.
Here we go.
Hey, team. It's Jason again. Just want to make sure you guys saw my last email. We'll be checking in tonight at the Marriott at 7:48. So make sure that you check in before dinner. We're having a happy hour afterwards. So, and then we're going to be attending a comedian. His name is Clayton Merhanahan. He's going to be joining us in the room C
for team
downstairs
building.
For team building.
Yes.
Of course. So bring your happiness.
Bring well your said. Happiness.
Well said. And the reason Jose asked me to turn off my cam is because when I do, it is Jason clearly about to go to a job interview. So
a LinkedIn photo, probably.
It's a solid glamour shot of him right there.
Yes.
Headshot.
Some people don't know what glamour shot means. Say, look, glamour shots.
Did you ever have? I had a girlfriend that gave me one of her glamour shots pictures.
Did you? A little wallet
that's,
size?
That's true love. Yeah. That's true love.
Wow.
Yeah, that
do
was
you still
like,
have it?
he's like, some possibly.
Just say no and move on.
Can you imagine my explaining
friend,
that to your wife?
One of my best friends growing up, her name was Ashley, and she went to my middle school, and then she ended up going to my high school, which is rare because we were kind of like out of district, but we were kind of like on the edge. Anyways, she had glamour shots. I think I still have hers.
Where do you keep these glamour shots
it's weird.
That you're holding on to?
It's weird.
You don't keep boxes of stuff?
You're the
my glamour
of my
shots
family,
of middle schoolers. I do not.
That, wait, that's why you got to make it sound like weird.
That's why
it
is.
Made it weird.
Kevin. It's not weird. It's like old pictures of your friends.
It's like something that
it's not like I'm jerking off to middle school. I mean,
I hope not.
Not since Tuesday, bro.
I wouldn't necessarily like be like, okay, I'm moving from my parents' house, so let me pack this box of glamour shots from middle school.
That's
my
not
parents
all they
it's just a box, Kevin. This glamour shots.
Right. Kevin walked around. Can I get one of your glamour shots?
Hey, you have any glamour shots I can
didn't
have?
Fucking ask.
Excuse me. Do you know how much a polar bear weighs?
No. How much?
Enough to break the ice. Hi, Fred Searing. How are you?
Weren't we supposed to play something before the opening item?
We were supposed to. Hey, team.
Come on, Poppy.
pretend none of that happened.
Play labeled video. Play after team is introduced.
All right. You introduce the team.
Go, team.
Team.
All hands in. All hands in.
What a penumbra.
Oh, penumbra.
How fucking up are those people, bro?
I go Panamba.
That was a video of
two
stoners going to Panera Bread. Panera Bread, and looks like the
EAD was
thank you. The EAD on bread was
not lit up.
Not lit up, so it was Panamba.
Panamba.
I like the last one. I like the last one the best.
Yeah. So, anyways,
yeah.
Opening
good.
Item. I don't know why we needed to play that right after the team was introduced.
Yeah,
but,
Here
we are. From Jason. What is one movie that had a great concept / potential you wish you could remake and do a better job? Chase, you are looking straight in my eyeballs like
I always I mean I get lost eyes. In your eyes, man.
Just my alive. Eyes are not that glamorous.
It's not that they're glamorous, it's the kindness and warmth you see in your eyes.
Who I do
are you looking at?
Kind,
what the fuck? Who are you looking at?
He's looking at me.
For me, there's one movie that like when I had this movie in mind when I came up with this question, which
don't
is In Time.
God damn it.
I did not dislike In Time, but I just feel like it could have been like so much better.
It was very
and I feel
average.
Like it could have opened up like sequels if they did a good enough job. There's just so much story you could tell there.
I didn't hate In Time.
I didn't
honest.
Hate it. I didn't
but
hate
it was
it
very
either.
Average.
Exactly. It's an amazing concept. It's an amazing concept to me. And an okay movie. Like with that good of a concept, I think it could be like a great movie.
Get some better actors,
so
actually
not,
have a good story, and then
yeah, it's not a bad movie. It's just not a great movie. And
Justin
I feel like
Timberlake,
it, I feel like it could be a great movie and lots of sequels because there's so much you could like a whole universe is just sitting there.
A whole universe.
A whole goddamn universe.
I got it, Chase. Let's write the movie. Let's pitch it.
Let's do it.
We have to think who's the lead actor. It's not gonna be Justin Timberlake. Not
no,
Justin
it's gotta
Timberlake.
Be Nick Lachey.
Who?
Ooh, I love that choice. I love that
Lachey.
Choice. I connect with Nick Lachey, man. When he was doing that show with, what's her dick?
Jessica Simpson. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, is when they were married.
His ex-wife?
Yeah. Like, he what was like, she would say like the dumb shit and he would be like the normal voice in the world, you know? And I'm just like one day, like, I remember on the show, he was like, there was like leaves or dirt on his driveway, and he was just spraying it off with a hose. And she was like, "What are you doing?" And he's like, "Just spraying the stuff off the driveway." And she was like, "Can't we like pay somebody to do that?" And he's like, "I could just do it, you know.
Like, I'll just do it myself.
Just so I'm doing it right now."
It's yeah, like, I love Nick Lachey.
Take and, me 12 minutes.
Yeah.
That's the only reason you love Nick Lachey.
He's also a sports guy. He's also a sports guy. A big Cincinnati Bearcats fan.
I feel like you know a lot about him.
A top 10 singer, obviously.
He is a great singer, so.
He's not any other J.C. Chazé, I'll tell you.
Well, and after he stars in
the
remake of
J.C. Chazé?
The prime voice of NSYNC. That's who it is.
Really?
The best singer in NSYNC.
Of NSYNC? You mean Justin Timberlake?
Yeah, I think Justin, you said the wrong name. I think
Justin Timberlake wrong.
Timberlake is whatever. What is, he's not.
He's whatever?
Excuse me?
JC's the star. JC's the star.
Is he the gay one?
No, that's Lance. What's wrong with you?
I don't fucking know.
He's trying to find your logic.
I'm trying to figure out what's going on here.
He's the prime vocalist.
There's one fight person me. In America that fight believes me. That.
As fight fucking me. Usual, a fucking Ronald Acuna, bases loaded, pops out. Goddamn piece of shit.
great. Kevin's kind of distracted tonight. Any
context Cubs Braves here? It's Cubs Braves. Cubs Braves week. So, you know, 3 out of the 5 people in this podcast are, you know, emotionally involved in this.
That's true.
Even though I got on the podcast and I was watching the game, and Chris was like, who's a Braves fan, was like, "I didn't even know they were playing."
I didn't say I didn't know we were
I'm
playing.
I didn't even know we were playing, bro. It's fucking, I was traveling Panera. The world.
Shop.
But anyways, Chris, what is your movie that had a great concept potentially and you wish you could remake and do a better job?
Yeah, there's this one I've been thinking about. It's this cool concept where they do time as the currency. It's called In Time, actually.
Okay, so you're picking the same thing regardless, even though...
Yeah, I didn't have a backup.
Okay, Chase Jose.
All right, so growing up, I was a big Power Rangers guy, kid. And the first Power Rangers movie was awesome because I was a kid, and I was with Ivan Ooze.
Ivan Ooze, baby.
The Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
Oh, yeah.
And just a few years ago...
Wait, why'd you say it like that? Is there a different Power Rangers?
Because, yeah, there's Power Rangers in space and...
Turbo whatever, Power Rangers.
Turbo Power Rangers.
Zero something. I don't know.
Yes. A lot. The Mighty Morphin Power Rangers are the ones of my time. And a couple years ago, we heard there was a new Power Rangers movie that was coming out. Looked really cool. Could have been really great. And it kind of disappointed a little bit. It had the talent there, but I feel like it could have been better. And
it's a
good
one.
Especially with the way that like 90s kids love anything that's nostalgic from that time. That could have been better. That could have been like a whole trilogy.
Oh yeah,
of movies. So it's a Power Rangers movie.
that's a good one.
Thanks.
Hey, it's a good one, man.
Who would you choose as your lead White Ranger?
Are you asking me the? I'm trying to. Which ranger? What color helmet does this ranger wear?
Wait, what do you mean white? White? What are you talking about?
I'm just saying.
All right, just cool. Curious. I guess you don't.
So
have
you don't have a you don't have a White Ranger helmet.
Yeah, who's your?
I don't even think the White Ranger was in that movie. The Red Ranger was the.
So who's your Red Ranger then?
Who's your captain?
Who's my captain? My captain would be, what's his name? Spider-Man.
Tom Holland. Tom Holland's beautiful.
Damn, the way your face lights up when you say
Tom Holland. I'll take him.
So would you have Zendaya be one of the Power Rangers?
Fuck yeah.
Who's that? Zendaya.
Zendaya.
Zendaya. Zendaya. Is that the girl that
pretty
is
badass.
His girlfriend?
Yes. Yeah.
Yeah. She's
the done like
new
porn,
movie
right?
Challengers.
Nope, she's been in Dune.
Not that I'm aware.
No.
She's done porn, right?
She's in Dune and Spider-Man.
Challengers.
What do you keep on? You wanted me to watch Challengers or something? Like, what's?
I don't know what that is.
It's her most latest movie.
For me, it's Waterworld. It sucks. like, I want to see it make fucking awesome. So
that's a good answer.
It fucking had a chance to be awesome, and it was terrible. And no
Turbo.
You know,
Turbo. It was Turbo.
Okay.
Yeah, go ahead.
Turbo.
Poppy,
cool.
Thank you, Jose. Turbo. Hey, kaleidoscope. Are we just saying words? Like, what is Turbo?
What do you mean? It's terrible. It's a terrible movie.
Oh, terrible.
I want to go Panurbo.
It's a great answer, Kev. Great answer.
We
got
to move on. We got to get the fuck out of here.
We got to get rolling quick.
This is bad. We need Jason.
It's a very
Jason also said after we watched that video, now enjoy having that stuck in your head the entire episode. It has been so far.
He's not wrong. It will be. It will come back.
So far, so good.
So the next segment we have, for those of you just joining us, is a great one of the best segments
Why
alive.
Did you start the podcast now if you're just joining us? That's what I'm worried, concerned about. You could have started it from the beginning.
For the next segment, folks, if this is your first time listening to the podcast, is what I meant to say.
Try that again.
This is where we're going to take a Florida headline and fill in the blanks. So we're going to leave some blanks out in a Florida news headline, and then you're going to fill in the blanks. So get excited for that. This is what we call Florida Man.
Ready. Come on.
You're ready?
Points. I need some points here.
What is up, guys? This is Florida Man. If Kevin or the boys haven't explained this segment yet to you guys, it's when I read a Florida Man headline, replace the word with blank, and you guys try to fill it in. Those rules still apply in this situation, but one thing does change. Get ready, Chase. I know the rules change and you guys fucking lose your goddamn mind. This time, I'm going to give you guys four options. And I'm going to put them right here the time that I say it. Damn it. I wish I had that like phrase said. Anyway, long story short, I'm going to read the headline. You guys are trying to fill it in. I'm going to give you the options you get to choose from. And you'll have a better opportunity to answer. And this time I don't have to be there. And one of you guys can't question and answer. And it's just the whole kind of thing because I fucked it up because I'm not there. And I'm really, really sorry. But that being said, let's get to four, man. This time... It's not out of a city. Sorry, I had gum all over my mouth. I know, Kevin. I'm sorry.
Okay.
But this time, it's actually out of a festival in Florida called Old Soul Fest 2024.
Oh, the Soul Fest.
Of course. Yes, I have to say it like that.
What's so hard about Soul Fest?
Okay. So this one, states as is. States.
Yeah, it'll work.
That's not a thing. Florida man blanks deputy during assault. I don't like the word deputy because I don't say it correctly or it sounds weird. Like ROADS.
Say it again.
Name that movie. Name that movie, Chase and Chris. Come on, think about it. Name it. ROADS. Limit. 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 Bet you guys can't figure it out. All right.
Nope. I don't know
Florida
what
man
he's talking about.
Blanks cop during assault. All right. This is an action. Chase, action. The guy
Got
does
it.
Something
action
to cop
chase.
During
Got it.
The assault. Okay. So he assaults the cop. What is he doing to assault the cop? All right, is it option A, option B, option C, or option D?
Oh, we got
A,
options.
B, C, D. Which one is it? I'll let you guys think.
Wait.
I'm really confused.
Okay.
Read God those options, I guess.
It was one was like bites a chunk out of his head.
Yeah, bites his
bites
dick,
his pinky.
Bites his pinky, bites his eyebrow.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So chunk from the head, pinky, eyebrow, or dick.
Does anybody remember what the Florida
Left
man
eyebrows?
Yeah, it's Florida assaults. Man assaults cop by blanking or something like that.
Yep.
Yeah. It's an action. Yeah.
Like
an
while
action.
He was getting
Chase
arrested, he did this thing.
Yeah.
And it's
eyebrow.
Pinky, head, eyebrow,
left,
and dick.
Left eyebrow. That could be.
That is too specific, actually.
I'm
going to
say. I'm going to say pinky.
Yeah, that's probably good.
I'm going chunk out of the forehead.
I'm going with the dick. I don't know.
All right. I think Kev's right.
Well, see.
All right, guys. So was it bites a chunk from his head? Was it bites his dick off, bite his pinky off, or bite his left eyebrow off? So Shumfrum said off. Dick off, his pinky off, better. Or his left eyebrow off.
Yeah, it's got to be pinky.
If you chose pinky, you're yeah. dumb shit, and you did not get it
correct. Oh.
If you chose dick off, though, you're still fucking dumb. And then, obviously, if you chose this one, you're just a piece of shit. Bites his eyebrow off. Come on, man.
Fuck.
What are we doing? The guy bit a chunk from his head. His head.
How does that
true,
happen?
True story. Chris, and if you're thinking, gotta be on drugs. 100% correct there, Chase. Backstory is, he was high on multiple drugs. This has to be some kind of Olympic record, including PCP, LSD, ketamine, mushrooms, ecstasy, and he was charged with assault. So...
Ding.
PCP, Ooh. LSD, ketamine, or is it ketamine?
Ketamine.
Ooh, say that. That's like rogue.
Ketamine.
That's insane. That is absolutely fucking insane. But yeah, you
you're insane, Jason.
Still Jason's only on three
right.
of those, right?
Put
now.
It on the board. If you got it correct, put it on the board. Put it on the board, and then let me know at a there. Time. Actually, I won't be home for like 2 more weeks. So just fucking let me know who wins.
Let me know in June.
All right, like,
bye.
You can
make your bed, man. Like, you're on the podcast. It's like, people
congratulations, Christopher.
Woo!
You're on the board, Chris. I got
first
you on the
Florida
first
man.
One.
First Florida man.
Not bad, mate. Absolutely not bad.
Not bad at all.
So yeah, it's a little weird because you know, like, he told us to read those things and we were supposed to like memorize them or something. But
I think we did a pretty good job remembering them, though.
I can concentrate without all the disaster in the background, man. You put your suitcase away or something, like.
Bro, Jose what, was so, bro?
Jose this is a professional podcast here.
This man's visiting like fucking. He's like visiting like four.
Why is your bed so messy?
In like
you're
2 days,
like,
you know.
You're one human being.
He's probably like spending one night there, and then he's off to the next place.
just kidding, Jay. No, I'm not.
Moving right so along.
You're very serious.
Chase, smile. Jesus Christ. I mean, Chase looks like somebody just murdered his fucking left Susan.
Ooh. By left
what?
Susan?
Yeah, dude. It happens. Yeah.
Okay. Oh, lazy Susan.
Well, I would be upset if they murdered my lazy Susan.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. I'm trying to find where the hell
lazy Susan is.
No.
Where is lazy Susan? Chase, how's the packing and the moving and the stuff coming?
It's coming slowly and stressfully.
It is the most miserable fucking thing that you could do.
It's awful.
Fucking move.
It is awful. I never want to do
sure
it again.
Doing it with two kids is a lot of fun.
Yeah, it's a lot.
Chase, I was going to read your novel, but I'll have to read it later. I was driving. I saw it on my watch. I'm like, yeah, I ain't reading that. No offense.
It's fine. Everything worked out. We're good to go. That's all that matters.
Cool. All worked out.
The dog's freaking out.
They're fine. Got a week to fill the pod, so gonna be a
busy the pod, not the podcast. People are gonna be confused.
Yes, yeah. And it's a trailer technically, I guess.
Come on, man. Pod.
Come
trailer
on.
Pod.
Clearly
come on.
My bad.
Yeah, we. You know the your setup is lacking a little bit.
The IKEA room is slowly falling apart.
I mean, next week's going to be the last. Next week will be the last week I do the pod from Colorado.
Oh.
You going to do something special for it? What are you doing?
Got to do some Colorado stuff.
Sure.
No, he ain't doing
shit.
What is some
Colorado?
What is some
fuck
Colorado
off.
Stuff?
Fuck off, Colorado.
You have to
ice it down.
Obviously, smoke some weed during the show. That's
you have
Colorado
to.
Thing.
You
got to
drink Coors Light. Only Coors Light.
I'm drinking a Mary Jane right now. It's the name
you
got to
drink
oh.
Coors Light.
Oh. A Mary Jane, he says.
Mary Jane ale.
Yeah.
All right, we got a
Chabra.
Fucker.
Mary Jane. Yeah, bitch.
We have a voice nugget, guys. Get excited. It's from an old friend of mine.
Of mine.
Her name's Naomi. It's I moan backwards.
I don't feel like she got enough volume on that. I'm going to play it one more
time.
Hit
it one more time with some volume. Maybe.
Yep.
There you go.
Her name's Naomi. It's I moan backwards.
people are gonna start like be like writing in the OnlyFans that, you know, that they want Jason back.
I mean, I hope he comes back. Yeah,
we kicked him off, but he also
told me he wasn't
back.
Gonna be here again. I was like,
2 weeks? 2 weeks in a row? By myself?
Hey, y'all, I'm on here. Sorry, I have been pretty gone.
You moan where?
I'm nonstop on the always. Anyhow, I'm still listening to the show all the time. I'm about a week behind right now. I just got done listening to the new lingo, and let me throw one at y'all if it wasn't on there. I don't remember, but chat is to replace bro or bra or whatever our kids want to call us today. Mm-hmm, it's now mm-hmm. chat instead of bro. So
chat.
Think about chat. Anyhow, I'll be catching up with Jason. Got
Get
kicked
on board
off
with it.
The show in the next couple days. See y'all soon. Not see y'all. Ha! Talk to y'all later and listen to y'all. Yeah, I'm knocking down the park, y'all. Bye.
Just hit the end button, girl.
She's like, I'm looking for it. Where's it? I gotta find it.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Yes. I'm not on board with chat. Is that
Yo,
what
what's up, chat?
That's a
what's
no.
What's up, chat?
What's up, chat?
Like, well, because like so many people are so used to like talking to like streams of people. Like, is that what it is? Like, they're just like, okay, what's up,
that's
chat?
That's a good point. That's probably what it
what's
is.
What's up, chat? What are your thoughts on this?
The fucking... The way we talk to people is just going to go away, you know?
Oh, Pod Poppy.
Oh,
I mean, do
Pod
you
Daddy's
disagree?
Not happy about that.
Like, think are about you, it, you know? Like,
you filling that dick up? Is that what you're doing right now?
I got it. I have to.
He's going to fill it up.
This
and
is, literally down. Takes half the episode of, like, 90% of the episode, that's all I do is just fill up
you're
this
preaching
fucking
to the fucking
tiny,
choir.
Fucking small.
It is tiny. I said it from the start.
We got a size queen. Watch out!
No, I'm talking about the hole in it, the fucking dick holes.
The dick is also small, though.
Yeah, I mean it's like a two beer queer.
It is.
Well, Chase,
as someone that had to drink out of it, it's you kill it.
Wait, your mouth has been on this?
As somebody who has put that dick in my mouth, I will tell you, it is a small dick.
The worst part, like if you could just fill it one time. And, you know, it'll take you 15 minutes to do it, but then not have to fill it again. That'd be fine. But you fill it, and then it's gone in 7 minutes, and you have to fucking fill it again.
Why would we buy the tiniest dick, too? Like,
that's what I'm saying.
Because it would be funnier if it was a bigger dick.
Jason bought it.
And it would be a bigger, like, you know, thing. Like, I could put...
Yes.
Wouldn't it be sweet if you could put, like, two beers in a dick and then fucking, you know?
Yeah.
And then,
Kevin just degroted a giant meaty cock.
Thank you.
But anyway, I moan. I moan. Thank you so much. No, I appreciate you chiming in. You know, we're looking forward to getting caught up and chat. Hey, what's up, chat?
What's up, chat?
Chat.
What's up, chat?
I'm fucking chat.
Chat.
Fucking killing it, dude.
I miss you, chat. But anyways, what else we got going on, boys? Chris, are you ready?
This ain't my thing.
Oh, it's another. It's another.
Is this random
surprise?
Twitter? Is this internet? Is this internet finds? This has nothing to do with me.
It's not random X finds.
I was preparing for another stupid fucking bracket.
Well, guess what? We're at another fucking week, and we haven't picked a bracket.
No brackets.
Keep coming.
Perfect.
No, keep coming.
We're doing the fucking 2000s movie bracket. Come on.
No, we got to do the bracket.
Chase, you haven't been very
bracket for the
outside
bracket.
Of this outside bracket, of bracket. You talking on the podcast. You have not been very thorough on like wanting that. You know,
I've said it a lot on the podcast though.
On the podcast,
where do you want me to just go on the street and say it? Like, what do you want me to tell?
Like, let the people know.
Let us outside. Know. You know, on the, let the chat know. You know?
Come on, tell all your chats.
Chat. Hey, chat.
Chat.
What's up, chat? I got a bracket, man.
All right, let's. We got some random internet finds. It's pretty self-explanatory, and it looks like our boy Jason found something for us. So get excited, and boys, if you want to unmute yourself in the middle of this talking, it's 30 seconds, so it's up to you. So fine, look and dry
your eyes. Okay. Yeah.
Can we go back? Okay. So
you can't go back.
I like the book fair. The Scholastic Book Fair.
So book it.
Ribbons on field day,
Burning a scratch.
I didn't care about that. Line leader, I didn't care about that.
Almost like
Did Jason forget this is a fucking podcast?
He forgot it's a podcast.
Why would you...
Jason, I appreciate you finding this. It is a podcast, so I guess do you want to play it again, and then we'll explain it as it goes.
Yes. Okay. I'll read them each.
Oh, so Jose's gonna read.
Jose's taking charge. Don't get.
I got. All right. Let's go. Let's go.
Sorry for the loudness. I can't turn it down. So here we go. Be so fine. Look
and dry your eyes. Jose, you were muted.
I know.
Damn it!
Jesus Christ.
You got right job.
All right. Let's go. Let's go. Run it again.
It's going to continue from here. So what was the first thing that said? 10 things.
Top 10 things that happened at school that made it the best day ever. The parachute thing. Rainbow parachute.
Yeah, where they like throw it up in the air and pull it down. I love that shit. But anyways, let's continue the video. Unmute yourself this time, Jose.
I am ready. Top 10 things that happened at school that made it the best day ever. The parachute in gym class. Going to computer lab
for organ training.
Seeing this roll into the classroom.
Movie day.
Cart. Pizza day. The Scholastic Book Fair. Best week ever. Receiving your bucket button. Winning ribbons on field day. Earning a scratch and stiff sticker on your work. Getting picked to be the line leader. Getting chosen to get something for the gym teacher. I don't know. That sounds weird. Yeah. What is the gym teacher making you go get?
Go get in footballs now, boy.
Go get in there getting
footballs.
Go run out to my truck and get me that beer. It's in the center console.
Get that
beer.
Move your ass.
When you go to
you have one sip out of it. Just one.
Oh, that would actually be then. Oye, papi, ve al carro y cógeme la cerveza que está por allá.
Sí.
Hola, Juan.
That's pretty sweet. Let me just say, book fair was my favorite time of the year, bro.
Awesome. Love that book
fucking
fair.
Book.
You walk into book fair with $10 and you feel like a king.
Bro, I had a wall of fucking great posters that I got from the book fair, Michael Jordan era. It was amazing time. The one where he's like soaring through the air on the dunk contest, book fair.
Mm-hmm.
The one that I didn't get from the book fair was my Sandra Bullock poster, half naked. Found that at Spencer's.
Spencer Gibbs, there it is. Shout out Spencer Gibbs.
Thank you for that.
Book fair was awesome. Also, they sold books.
Believe it or not, they did have
believe
books.
It or not,
they sold
it,
books.
It was indeed.
So that was cool, and you could get some fun pencils
and erasers. Yeah, all the fucking good stuff.
Back then, like all the Ninja Turtle shit,
educational.
Mm-hmm. Chris, you want to talk?
I used to get all the goosebumps.
The chewing of the gum.
What's that?
The Goosebumps books.
Goosebumps, okay. Yeah. It's a good time to upgrade the Goosebumps books, for sure. Yeah.
I used to have like a whole wall of all the Goosebumps books. Are you talking about me chewing my gum, Jose? Is that what you're laughing about?
I feel like I'm in your mouth right now.
You're welcome.
Well, no, I don't.
Are you drinking? Are you eating Neuro Gum just for the...
Yeah. Keep that energy up.
Is it low?
Shout out Neuro Gum. Louder.
Is it low?
I mean,
No, it's not low.
You've been traveling the world. You were... Current, like at the beginning of the
Across
day, you
three
were in
states. I was in
you
Florida.
You were in Florida, so you know, here you are. Chase, you what was your favorite part of that
random
Oregon Trail, bro? Oregon
Trail was also fun.
Yeah. Computer lab was the shit, man.
Oh, yeah, when it was like on the computer lab game
number
time.
Crunchers. You remember that one?
Mm-hmm. Nope.
I do indeed. Yeah, I hated it because I suck at math. so that was not fun.
The AV cart was always fun when
that rolled in. You're like movie day,
but you never know.
Sometimes they put on the stupidest shit, and they're like, also take these notes and like answer these questions.
If I can't take a nap, fuck you, bro. Like when you're like, take notes on this, and
exactly they roll
Aladdin,
in and you get so excited. They get so excited, and they're like, all right, this is a documentary on mosquitoes. I'm going to need you to write a 2-page paper on them. Like, fuck.
I'm in second grade.
Yeah, well, you better start writing.
So my name is
true,
Kevin.
Chase. It was so great until they were like, they like rolled it in. They're like, oh, fuck, there's a movie today. And then it's like, It's like, we're going to watch a short documentary on Albert Einstein and his lifestyle. He's like,
it's going to be the most boring documentary ever made.
God, no.
There was actually a really interesting one on Albert Einstein, and we said no.
We said no.
No. We took the boring one instead.
We're also going to make it as hot as we possibly can in this class.
And, we're turning the heat up, actually.
We also know that you're very sleepy in it, so, you know, just fight it. If you don't take notes, yeah, then you fail this
class. Make sure you take those notes.
Automatically. Automatically fail.
You're like finding your like you're trying your best during the class. It's like nodding off and on.
I don't know if I'm the only person in the world, but I didn't think that the square pizzas were really that good.
It's the novelty of it, the rarity of it.
I was never that excited about it.
I never even thought about the pizza day as a kid. Like, I was just like, pizza, eat it. You know, I wasn't like, this is good or bad.
You weren't like, fuck yeah, pizza. Yeah,
I wasn't eat, like food, fucking eat. Dave Portnoy as a kid. Like,
going to review
one review bite, your everybody knows the rules.
Oh, I'll give this a, 6.8. It's like,
it's not bad.
I've had better school pizza. The middle school was a little better.
Crust could be a little crispier. No, that never happened. So. I don't know.
It was always Fridays, right? Wasn't Friday pizza?
It was typically Friday.
Couldn't tell you.
Damn, bro.
I mean, all those foods were about the same, which is average to below average.
In my school in Pensacola, Florida, this can't be high school. We got excited Fried Chicken Day. Fried Chicken Day. Which I found out is still a thing. So they still serve fried chicken there. Mashed potatoes.
That's cool. Damn.
I think they had corn back then with some gravy. Mm-hmm. We used to fucking just tear it up, man. If you didn't eat it, like, hey, can I get yours, man? You gonna eat that? You gonna finish that?
I can hold that. I can hold the rest.
People
of
don't do
there?
That shit nowadays.
What do they give you, like a breast and a leg? Like, what are we talking here?
Look at how curious Chase is. Yeah. Like, I need to know proportions. Lisa.
Yeah. Is it all? Is it? You got a combination of dark and white, or
you get your choice? Maybe
good question.
I couldn't tell you. I still to this day do not see color, so
he's still colorblind.
Black or white doesn't matter to me. Yeah,
no.
Fucking.
Moving on.
Right
along.
Anyway, was folks. Go ahead.
No, Jose. I was like, was there anything from like middle school, high school lunch that you remember? Like. Kevin remembers the fried chicken, obviously.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah, in elementary school, they did like a baked potato with like chili on top. And I actually liked it.
Yes.
I'm sure
it
tore my little fucking elementary.
That's a crazy thought that you like that.
In elementary school, like a lot of kids are really picky in elementary school.
Can you imagine little like elementary school Chase eating that?
Well, I
so good.
So why does it sound like a fucking goddamn like?
The reason I remember this is because I remember they like had it for lunch, and I was like, "Oh my god, it was so good!" And I came home and told my parents, I was like, "For dinner, I want a baked potato with like meat on top," and they're like, "What are you talking about?
Can I have a baked potato with some meat on it, please?"
My kid came up and said that to me. I'd do the same shit.
Yeah, they're like, "What are you?
Go to your room. You're grounded."
I don't know what it was, but it was like a baked potato with like a meat thing on top. They're like,
"Go to your room right now."
Like, we don't know how to make
straight
that,
to your room.
So
I'm fucking sick of you.
Go to your room, Chase.
That's the only reason I remember that.
I can't remember too many things, but I know I know that there was a there were corn dogs.
I remember
corn
dogs.
And there was
Kevin is peeing, chat.
So just for
later, chat.
For those of you that are wondering what we're laughing at, Kevin said, "I'm not even gonna say shit. I'm just gonna go pee."
He puts on a classic video of a clip from Dumb and Dumber.
He couldn't wait the 5 minutes till 7 minutes in heaven.
We have rapid fire. Minutes in heaven.
Baby bladder can never make it.
We had Jamaican beef patties, and they were like surprisingly really good.
That's
really
unique.
Good. Yeah. Elementary, middle, or high school?
High school.
I was about to say that high can't school. Be elementary. That would be crazy for elementary school when they just give you like fucking chicken tenders.
Yes. They had like a breakfast, like basically it was like a Jamaican beef patty, but it was like breakfast, like
that's
stuff
awesome.
And like eggs and sausage and stuff. That was the only reason that I went and got breakfast at school.
That's legit.
And one of the reasons why I was like fucking 300 pounds. But but that's
I heard
back
that.
In the day.
Back in the day.
Chris, one day a week you Shocking. Ate, what did you like?
Shocking.
My one day a week, well, I remember at Child's, they had Chick-fil-A sandwiches they had
of
in the
course.
Cafeteria.
Jesus, of Chick-fil-A course. It's wow. Child's, bro, it's Child's.
Child's had Chick-fil-A sandwiches. Well, that was for real.
Child's, motherfucker.
Well, that was...
They
can I say something?
Probably.
I don't
We've
think so.
Got Chick-fil-A no. sandwiches.
Well, that was only for like the underclassmen, because when you're a junior senior, you went off campus for lunch.
Yeah, yeah. And obviously on Fridays, they also would, you know, bring in Ruth Chris. So.
Well, yeah. Well, you,
no, the actual
Ruth
guy.
Chris Friday.
Ruth Chris.
Yeah, yeah. He showed up and was like, hello, Childs. I have your steaks.
He's I'm
like,
here for you guys. So
he individually cooked 1,200 steaks.
Yeah. Like, they made the mashed potatoes fresh that morning.
Chris, do you like it? You still like it medium rare? We're going to switch it
you
up
know,
today?
I'm going to be wild. I'm going to go medium today. Cooking a little bit longer today.
Whoa. Chris, no problem at all. We'd be happy to serve you. Just tell
you
your parents
you want
to keep
some garlic butter on top? You want a little garlic butter on top?
Yeah, we'll go rowdy. We'll put some garlic butter on it today.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. Rowdy? I haven't heard that word in a minute.
Yeah, chat.
So rowdy.
Yeah, chat.
Yeah. What's up, chat?
One thing that was... What we got excited was Subway, which was always there. They'd have like pre-made sandwiches that they'd sell. Only the rich people got those, though. Like if you were eating Subway, like you were like,
it was a status symbol.
Yeah, it was 100% a status symbol. Like we'd be like, oh, this dude.
Did they all sit at the same table? It's like this over is the here. Subway table.
Subway table over here. Come on.
Kevin tries to like bring his like home packed lunch and like ooh
hey
this,
guys
the seat's
table.
Taken actually sorry about
in
that
his little Green home Bay pack. Packers lunchbox his little Brett Favre hey, lunchbox
you get your free and reduced lunch okay I don't know
he's got his Tom Cruise lunchbox
when you're poor you get free lunch okay
like the rich people in my high school they ate Papa John's Sun Chips and
good choice
the lemonade
I assume.
Yes. Yes.
Obviously.
The canned lemonades. That was the move.
The canned like, lemonades.
What the fuck is canned lemonade?
The Minute Maid.
Yeah, the Minute Maid
lemonade.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. That was it. I was like,
that's what
you. I would look at those kids like, maybe one day.
I want to get there. I want Sun Chips one day.
Papa John's and a canned lemonade.
I hate fucking school lunches. On our game days, our coach would give us electrolyte pills.
What?
Yeah.
No, that was
you
meth.
Better take
he
this pill,
you
boy.
Meth, Kevin.
I took meth.
He's like, you're about to run through a goddamn wall, kid.
He gave us all Adderall.
These are your electrolytes. Wink.
Wink
enjoy.
Wink. The other team's like, those kids are fucking tweaking.
Let's fucking play.
Foaming at the mouth.
Come
into
on.
Into the game, we're just passed out. No, it was electrolyte pills, you know?
Sure. Yeah, sure it was.
Totally. Totally.
But anyways. All right, next segment. Kind of excited. It's been a Ooh. Minute. You know, we're going to go ahead and do this. We thought random internet finds would suck. Didn't suck. So sorry about that.
Didn't suck. So here we are.
But we
it
got
was
rapid,
actually a really good one, but we got rid of it.
It would have been better. Fire. It would have been a better one if they actually said what it was instead of just.
Or Jason
like,
said it. Yeah. You know, just be like, hey, what do you guys think? But no.
Nope.
This is rapid fire. Chase, just keep your headphones off while you're at it. There you go. Chase will be the first to sit out rapid fire, so it'll be. Jose and Chris, but in the meantime, let me play.
I'm gonna give you to the count of 10 to get your ugly, yellow, no good keister off my property before I pump your guts full of lead. All right, Johnny, I'm sorry. I'm going. 1, 2, 10.
Let's do some rapid fire, shall we? Oh man, I really need to redo that. That's so anyways, Chase is gonna sit this round out. It's gonna be Jose and Chris answering these 17 rapid fire
Let's go.
Questions. Keep Ooh, in mind 17. That the main purpose of rapid fire questions is to answer them rapid firely.
What?
So yeah,
Chuck.
So fucking answer it. Don't sit there and think about it and just fucking do it.
3 seconds right? or less.
Here we go.
You two ready?
Here we go. Let's go.
Yep.
Give it to me.
He's so ready.
Most
Pop-poppy.
Used app on your phone.
Twitter.
Instagram.
Last item you purchased, not gas.
Picture frame.
Haircut. Does that count?
Sure.
Sure, that'll work.
Okay. Celebrity you hate.
Ooh.
This is a tough one. Who do I hate?
Jesus.
Said his fucking name. What is this fuck? Is he? I don't know.
Tom Holland. Celebrity.
No, the Tom dude Holland. That owns Barstool. He's fucking
Dave Portnoy? Portnoy.
Dave Portnoy. Portnoy. Yeah.
Portnoy.
Dave Portnoy. Logan Paul. Can't think of him.
Celebrity crush.
Margot Robbie.
Easier for you guys.
Jason Kelsey.
Okay. Reaction you'd have if that celebrity winked at you while you were with your significant other.
Immediate what? Boner.
100%.
You would have a boner? That would be your immediate reaction.
Yeah.
Your significant other's right there.
Yeah.
I'd be like,
probably have one too. We'd both have boners.
I'd be like, that's fucking Margot Robbie, babe. She fucking winked at me. Mm-hmm. She'd be jealous, actually.
Maybe she's into it.
Hey.
What are
gotta
you
make a dream come true.
Hey.
All right, rapid fire, guys. Focus.
Come on.
In.
I'm back in.
Okay, what are you addicted to?
Porn.
Porn.
Do the size of areolas matter?
Nope.
No, they don't matter.
That means
the nipple matters.
You deal with big ones. I see it. which Saved by the Bell character best describes your penis?
I don't know any of their names.
Probably Skeeter, because he's not like the everybody loves him, but he's not the best to look at.
I think you mean Screech and
Screech.
Yeah, I'm now realizing that this is that 3 year, 5 year gap.
I will also say Screech because I don't know any of their names.
Zach,
AC Slater,
I don't Kelly.
Kelly, nope. Whatever.
Screech it is.
Okay. Wow, that was fail on my end.
Like shit.
If you had to keep one item for the rest of your life, what would it be? That means you have it and you need to keep it.
My flashlight.
Okay.
My cell phone.
I don't have a flashlight.
Let's hear you go back to this morning. I don't know why I said let's hear you. Go back to this morning and give yourself advice for the day.
Drive safe, actually.
Drive safe, like that.
Jose, try
to remember that this is rapid fire.
I'm trying to. I know what I want to say. I would tell myself that it's not worth driving in a fucking monsoon to go get a haircut. I can go get one tomorrow.
What's your favorite bug? This should be a little bit easier.
Ooh.
Ladybug.
There you go. Jesus,
love
Jose.
Bugs. Nobody loves
bug?
Love bugs.
Oh,
nobody
no.
loves love bugs.
Jose, this is either or, so, I mean, fucking try to answer it, okay? Sausage or hamburger?
Hamburger.
Sausage.
Okay. Your favorite podcast outside of Cup to Cup?
Ooh.
We know.
Jeff
Kristen,
Cameron.
The Makeshift Project, right?
That's not him. Sorry, guys. That was my chance to shout him out more. Fuck.
Is Jeff Cameron a podcast, or is it just a
No, it's a podcast, too.
Okay.
8 hours of white noise for sleeping. I listen to it every night.
So you do not listen to podcasts outside of Cup to Cup is what you're starting
to say.
He
only listens to our podcast.
Why else? All
right. Which sport has the sexiest athletes?
Football. What do you mean? You're just talking.
Which sport has the sexiest athletes? You think football has the sexiest athletes? You have something you want to tell us?
No, then
you don't have to tell. No, you don't. You can only whenever you're ready, Chris.
No,
soccer.
Whenever you're ready.
I didn't understand the question. Then soccer.
What do you mean?
Whenever you're ready, Chris. No, he took it. You can think that they're sexy. He can think that the men are sexy and not be gay.
Yeah, 100%.
You said sports. I went all the big sports.
Chris, go for it. Chris, stick with it. No, football. Chris says football. Next.
Football.
Football.
You said football, Jose?
Baseball.
Baseball, okay. And which show are you watching right now? Holy shit. God.
Not really watching. The last one I was watching was Tokyo Vice.
I fucking got stoners. I should have threw one non-stoner in this fucking...
What was the show?
The Bear.
Oh,
The Bear, and what are you watching, Chris?
Tokyo Vice.
Tokyo Vice.
The fuck is that?
It's on HBO. It's on Max.
One thing. What is one thing you still have from your childhood? It's funny. We were talking about this earlier.
Ooh, I have my my fucking, what's the thing called from Home Alone? The recorder. Talk boy. I have my talk boy. I found it in the garage yesterday.
That's nice. I've got one of my hats from when I was like 8. One of my old baseball hats.
Still fits perfect.
I don't know about fits perfect, but I have it.
Final answer. Thank God we've made it. Three word answer to best describe your last terrible performance in bed.
Way below average.
Frustratingly awful. Whiskey dick.
Okay. Now that's an extra. What's...
Chase is watching the game. He's not watching me. Hey, Chase.
Hey.
Do you want the good news or the bad news?
I want the great news.
The great news is whatever you say is going to be the best thing we've heard so far. So
Jesus.
These guys fucking terrible.
I can't tell you're being serious.
Well, we're going to find out. Maybe it was the person that wrote the questions. Who knows?
My questions, I guess. So I do apologize. 17 questions for you, Chase. Are you ready?
17 questions. Let's do it, brother.
That's pretty normal, by the way. most used app on your phone, Chase.
Facebook.
Old ass man.
Every Tuesday, Thursday, brother.
Last item. Every Tuesday and Thursday is the last app used on your phone.
I'm saying I use it a lot on those days specifically for the emoji game.
2 days a week. Anyways, last item you purchased, not gas.
Red Bull.
It is indeed. What flavor was it?
Dragon fruit.
Dragon fruit.
That's a good one. That's a good one.
Yeah, it was good.
Chase, who's a celebrity that you hate?
Kirk Herbstreit.
And who is your celebrity crush?
Natalie Portman.
And what would be the reaction you'd have if that celebrity winked at you while your significant other was right next to you staring into your eyes?
I mean, my jaw would drop.
do the size of areolas matter, like in your opinion?
No.
Okay. And which Saved by the Bell character best describes your penis? And Saved by the Bell is a show in the 90s.
Okay. Ashley Slater.
Thank you, Chase.
Why?
Cause you know he gets shit done.
Cause he's the biggest one on the fucking show. That's why.
Jose is not wrong, and now all of a sudden Jose knows all the characters on Saved by the Bell, which he did not know any 3 minutes ago. So
I knew more than Chris.
Hey, come on, man.
I knew more than Chris.
Go back in time to this morning and give yourself some advice for the day.
Don't stress.
Aw, pumpkin. Aww. Who's your favorite bug, Pumpkin? Your favorite bug?
Do spiders count? Spiders.
Sure. Yeah, spiders. Oh,
why?
Because
I eat all
spiders.
Other shitty bugs. Yes.
I see what you're saying. Sausage or hamburger?
Hamburger.
Ooh.
Homophobes, everyone here.
Chase, what's your favorite sausage, too? Hey, Chase. Kevin. No, it's okay. Welcome in, dude. We're doing rapid fire here. Hey, what's your favorite podcast outside of Cup to Cup?
Wake Up War Chant.
Ugh.
I like to call that one Sleeping War Chant. I know. Because it puts me back to sleep. I wake up and then they start talking.
I mean, Seminole Headlines is up there too. But
which sport has the sexiest athletes?
Soccer.
Damn, he... Chase is straighter than Chris. All right.
100%.
No. I will explain that.
It's okay.
He said football.
Chris, it's okay.
I will explain myself.
Chris,
he means the lingerie bowl. That's
no,
what
he
means.
No, he does not.
Hey, guys.
He means let's go back. Some finish really attractive men.
We'll finish up, and then we'll go back and revisit.
He's secure enough with his masculinity.
Hey, Chase, which show are you watching?
House of Dragon.
Rewatching, getting ready
for the rewatch.
Season 2 is about to come.
One thing that you still have from your childhood.
Pokemon Yellow.
Oh,
on Game Boy Color. On Game Boy Color.
100%. That's the one you got Pikachu in.
Question number 17. Three words to describe your last terrible performance in the bed.
My last what?
Terrible performance in the bedroom.
Still pretty great.
Ooh, okay. Hey.
That's good.
Very good. Very good.
Still like pretty it. Great.
Oh, that's all right. A good, you should go ahead and play that Fuck Me Big Daddy.
Yeah, it doesn't work when you tell me to do it and then I do it.
So I'm trying to help you here. It's just like that would be a good that would have worked really well.
Okay, see, good. So things that we want to revisit, right? Mm-hmm. So let's first talk about.
There seems like one.
Facebook being the most used app on Chase's phone. I thought was funny.
What is y'all's most used app? I mean, Twitter's up there too.
I mean, Twitter's sure. by far.
It really
the
should
one
be
on
Twitter,
so.
But I think it might.
It
be
probably
Instagram
yeah. It probably is Twitter now that I think about it. But I do use Facebook a pretty good amount, especially like coming up with the emoji game and checking answers for it, and our amazing CTC OnlyFans.
Good plug. Good plug. So. Good plug.
I just want to say, and I know that we haven't talked about this on the podcast before, but I think all of us can take some credit for the fact that Twitter is the most used app on your phone now, because you were really holding out for the longest time on making a Twitter account until
you
we bullied
me,
you
I'm
into
not good
it.
With, I'm not good with change and social media in general.
You're welcome.
Yeah.
Just say thank you. It's fine.
Thank
but
you.
But now,
fine.
I mean, it's gone a little downhill, but yeah, sure.
Size of areolas, like, you guys do not care about
could not
the size
care
of
less.
Area.
Yeah,
so giant fucking goddamn
does not matter. Could be bolognese. I don't care.
A whole
bolognese could be a whole bologna
that,
there.
Bro. I can't. That's like the opposite of sexy for me. Like,
can't see a bologna.
It's,
like,
it's a turnoff. It's a turnoff for me, 100%. What was the other one? Chris. Saved by the Bell character, Chase, just let me tell you, Chris had no idea what Saved by the Bell was.
No, what? I know what it is. I didn't know any of the characters' names.
He said,
Zach Morris's trash? Come on, what are we doing?
I don't.
And then
I know
also,
you talk about that
Jose
video
was very
time.
Confident and said Skeeter.
Skeeter.
Wrong.
Is Doug? A,
we're doing
a Doug character. Yes. Oh. Yeah. So, you know, great Screech. Job on everybody there.
All that shit Kelly. You talked about how
maybe
you would have gotten that name that show Doug and maybe you would have guessed Saved by the Bell.
I'm still thinking it.
You see that shade he's throwing at you, Jose? He's like, you see that shade?
I know. I see him.
Man's up 2 points and just
when
talking
when
that
it's
shit.
Teed up right there.
Did learn tonight that Jose does not listen to podcasts. So that's
other than ours.
I listen to one every single night when I go to bed. It's white
What's
noise
that?
For 8 hours.
I don't think that's
Jose,
a podcast.
What is
it's
that?
It's on the podcast.
Is that an inside joke that I don't know about or something?
I'm not inside with that joke, though, if it is.
Doesn't even make sense.
Did you ask Chase what he was obsessed with?
Obsessed with?
Huh?
Was that
a
question?
That's not a question, no.
No, the addicted one.
Addicted one.
Yeah, I don't think you did ask him that.
Oh,
he
no, I did not.
To.
Hey, Jose,
good catch,
Chase, what
man.
Are you addicted to?
Oh, sports, for sure.
You're Bro. Addicted to sports?
Yes, dude. Oh. I literally watch
winning. I'm addicted
sports
to
way
winning,
too much, man.
To never losing.
You got the raspy
way
voice
too much
sound. Good job.
What, though? I don't hey. Think you watch sports way too much.
I watch
much.
A fuck ton of sports.
Okay. All right.
A fuck ton, Kevin.
I mean, hockey, baseball, basketball, soccer.
UFL.
I do watch some of that, yeah.
Why are you watching that?
Because they have XFSU players.
Okay, he's addicted. Yeah, that's true. He's addicted. That's right. He's addicted.
That's an addiction.
He's addicted. He's watching just for the old players. I give you that.
Bro, if I had the like minor league baseball thing, I would watch minor league Braves baseball.
No, you wouldn't.
Yes, I would.
After hearing this, right. I think he would, actually.
I would.
I think his 100%, addiction
but
is
I'm not going to pay for it. So maybe it's not an addiction.
Well,
I don't
Chase.
Think Stream East is throwing minor league games on there.
We
Sorry.
Appreciate you talking about
no, they,
sports.
They have a minor league streaming site. No, they do. You can pay for
we
it.
Believe
yeah.
you. We all believe you. Nobody's denying that they are.
Chris did.
They do.
Chris said they I don't did. Stream it. Yeah, they do.
Well, Chris is, you know.
What?
He's Chris.
he's watching, he's sure watching football.
Folks, right now we are going to take a little break and go do our seventh inning stretch where we do 7 minutes in heaven. We're going to go talk about sports for like 7 minutes, maybe a little bit longer. If you haven't listened to the episode, go right now and listen to it. It's currently on your whatever you're listening to.
Podcast app.
And you know. I don't think
right next
app.
To the white noise
podcast app or where you listen to your podcast.
Yeah. Also, very weird answer, Jose.
It's not a lie. I mean, that's
I believe you that it's there.
And
it's
fucking
just...
listen to a podcast, bro. Like, put some knowledge
I
on
I listen
yourself.
To podcasts. Like, I listen to Talking Yanks like every week.
So why didn't
why,
you
why wasn't that
say
answer?
That?
Because the question was, what do I listen to the most, right?
Nope.
Nuh-uh. Wrong.
Oh, it was, what do I listen to besides Cup to Cup?
Run it back, Kevin. Fuck it.
Your favorite podcast outside of Cup to Cup is Word for Word.
White Noise. White Noise over Yankees. Wow. Yeah,
well, it is my
White Noise is not a podcast. Stop saying White Noise. God damn it.
It really is. It's a podcast. It's a podcast. It's a podcast. Right here.
Unbelievable. See? I don't want to see it.
Relaxing
don't ever show
white
it to
noise.
Me.
You play White Noise off of your phone?
Yeah, right before I go to bed.
I'll buy you a fucking sound machine.
Yeah, they're like, do you need $7? Like, yeah, I got you, bro. Like,
Kevin, if he wins one of these bets against me and Chase, he'll owe you $7.
No, he will not.
Oh, sorry. No, he won't, actually.
Yeah.
Keep using your phone, then.
Anyways, we'll be right back. We're going to go do some sports talking. BRB.
PP.
Bye.
A few moments later. A few inches later. 2 hours.
Anyway, folks, we are back.
okay.
We are indeed back. Hey, if you have not seen Conan O'Brien's Hot Ones, go check that out after you listen to our 7 Minutes in Heaven episode. Yes, of course, Jose, make sure you get that in before, because YouTube is okay with that, I'm sure.
Come on, chat. Rip it, chat.
What are you talking about? What are you talking about?
Nothing. Hold on.
Get that dick.
Get that dick. Sorry, just drinking out of my dick as punishment. Speaking of punishments, I am working on the video. Mm-hmm. We got a little bit done. I want to make sure it's a good one, so I don't want to rush the video out. But it is being currently worked on. My punishment
don't
video.
Don't ever rush it out.
When I was forced to have people walk me across the road in Jacksonville Beach, so it was super fun. Had a fun time doing it. Had a fun time filming it.
Now would you say that was your favorite punishment you've had to do?
I was like, let me take a second and think of all the goddamn punishments.
I did not enjoy getting my chest waxed. So that was no fun.
It seems like you don't enjoy drinking out of the dick.
Yeah.
The photo shoot?
Photo shoot wasn't terrible.
I think he liked the photo shoot, actually.
You're wrong on that.
I thought you looked beautiful. I thought you looked beautiful.
You pulled it off. I looked at the side by side and I was like, I'm looking at the same picture.
Yeah.
I don't know which one's
which. It's more in my environment because when we were walking up, he was like, oh, are you nervous to talk? Are you nervous? I'm nervous for you. I was like, what are you nervous for? What's going on? He's like, just like talking to strangers. And I was like, brother, I talk to strangers all day, every day. Like, that's what I do for a living. I'm in sales,
I feel like you and Jose, that's the most suited to your personalities, for sure.
And we talked about it, like, afterwards. We were like, man, that was good. It was fun. And then we were like, man, what if Chris or, Chase would have won? Would have it been? And we were like,
that's good. No.
Like,
It would have been cringier. That's for sure.
That's what we were saying. We were like, it would have been. It may not have been as good because the way you talk to people, but it might have been better.
Go on.
The way you speak.
It might have been better because you guys would have been more scared or maybe not as comfortable, talking to people. It might have been better that way.
I feel like if you approach somebody like confidently, they're more likely to not feel anxious with you. So it may have been just shitty for everyone.
You will see, indeed. There was definitely some friendly, and there was some definitely
not as friendly.
Not so friendly.
Yeah, so we'll see.
I'm excited.
Two beer queer. The video's coming here soon. And you're not allowed to say queer on here, okay? This is a Cup to Cup podcast.
You just did it.
Folks, we got to get this ball rolling. We are fucking rolling all night. I mean, it is 2 hours and 23 minutes into this recording, and we haven't even gotten to...
You know what, Pod Poppy? Go ahead and hit the music.
Mm. Oh, no.
For wasting time.
Yet.
Do it.
Oh, shit. No, I thought you'd be ready. I figured you had your finger on it. What is up, my people? It is time, once again, for another edition of This Is Where We Fucked Up. The weekly fact-checking segment on the podcast where I call out the mistakes of the previous week. It's been 2 weeks in a row. 2 weeks without Jay, which means that the most consistent segment on this podcast is really having to do some fucking work to uncover some new fuck-ups. Because I have no more freebie mispronounced words, and it's the same thing again this week. But, let's see what we got. Episode 251 did not feature Jason, as I mentioned, but it did feature supporter of the show, Dustin Cosgrove. We haven't mentioned Dustin this week. Dustin was with us last week. If you haven't heard that episode, go back and take a listen. It was fun having Dustin on for the recording of our two weekly shows. But did Dustin make it through his cup-to-cup sequester without fucking up? Well, what do you say we stop wasting any more time and just dive right in. This is where we fucked up in episode 251. We kick it off this week with Dustin. Welcome to the family, buddy. You fucked up real bad when you played that stupid emoji game on our on our OnlyFans, and you decided that you were going to win. What you kept from it? I don't know. Maybe next time that you want to be good at cup-to-cup games, you'll be a little more prepared. You'll know what to expect. You'll be having to hold your phone remarkably still for about 2.5 hours and be stuck in a virtual box with us. But hey, now that you have officially, you have a point on the big board and a fuck up to your name, we can really, truly, officially say that you are a member of the Cup to Cup family. Mm-hmm. Love you, buddy. Never escape now. So welcome in, my friend. Last week, Kev and I did that thing that we can't help but do almost weekly, where we break into song and interrupt the podcast. We do this pretty consistently. Lots of different songs throughout the time.
I wanna know what love is.
Prime example.
I actually need you to stop doing that
because last week when we started singing an outstanding rendition of Bon Jovi's "It's My Life," Chase, of course, hated it. And then said something about us possibly getting sued by John Bon Jovi for doing that, which really got me thinking, can you get sued for not playing a song without somebody's permission, but singing a song on like a platform, like a podcast? I was convinced not.
No idea.
And
I would have thought not as well.
Well, I did some research. Hashtag research was done. And you can sing a song in public without infringing copyright if you pay a performance fee to the rights holders of that song. Jason has left us alone for 2 weeks, and he's going to come back to lawsuits from Fox Sports and John Bon Jovi. But that's what happens.
No big deal. Minor people.
Why is John Bon Jovi suing us? This is really actually Jason's fuck up. Jason, you fucked up by leaving us alone for 2 weeks.
100%.
You did it.
You fucked up, Jay. You trusted us. Should never do that. Kev, during the show and 7 minutes, you brought up the roast of Tom Brady. When you were talking about the different comedians in attendance, you slipped one in particular, and this triggered Mayor Adamson, who apparently is really sick and tired of you doing this, so he contributed a little something.
He's sick and tired.
Kevin, there is no L in Bert Kreischer's name. There never has been.
I'm not the only one that cannot pronounce this motherfucker's name, okay?
Quote, but you get a big L every time you say it wrong.
I get a big L? Is that what I get? You motherfucker.
Stupid ass bitch.
Was that you or him that said that?
I don't know where the quote ended, actually.
Somebody in the fucking roast actually was like, Bert Chrysler, Chrysler. I don't even know how the fuck
Chrysler.
Something like that. You know?
That's 100% what Kevin was thinking.
Yeah. Fuck that. Don't
know. Thank you. Maybe we can, you know, treat our own with some respect and say their names correct.
Spell his name, Kevin. Spell his name.
Fuck you, Jason.
You got to listen to 7 Minutes in Heaven to know what we're talking about there. But Kevin does like to spell names. This one is spelled K-R-E-I-S-C-H-E-R. No L. No L.
Thank you for that, Jose.
Mayor
Adams. Big support of the podcast.
Wow. For the supplemental research. We got one last fuck up, and that one belongs to Kev.
Me.
Kev, oh. My buddy. And Chase, you're off scot-free. Chris, well,
good thing Chris is off scot-free because he had to go scot-free.
Even here.
He had to go so poop and take shots on the toilet.
I'm glad that you could just walk away during segments like that, you son of a bitch. Chase, you yesterday when you were introducing, not Kevin, when you were introducing Chase last week, you referred to him, and you did this on this week's 7 Minutes of Heaven, you referred to him as Chase McDowell. Chase McDowell, who you said was a major league
Mike
pitcher
or something.
For the White Sox. And you said that this was a major league pitcher for the White Sox. And that our well-endowed buddy and fellow pod co-host reminded you of him because his name is Chase. But something about that didn't sound right. So a little hashtag research did confirm that. Congratulations, Kev. Chase McDowell is a pitcher. He was drafted Major League Baseball out of Rice University.
Not by the White Sox.
By the Washington Nationals in 2014. Went 1-0 in the Gulf Coast National Single-A team. National Single-A team.
Well, as a Gulf Coast guy, you know, that's definitely where I was thinking.
That's it, right? He pitched two games and disappeared from pro baseball.
Well, he's still a human being, so let's not... Let's have some respect.
He's gone. Rest in peace.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
His career was definitely not as impressive of a run, and definitely not the McDowell that you were looking for. It is Jack McDowell, also known as Black Jack, who you were looking for.
Whoa.
It's a game. Uh-huh. He pitched most notably for the Chicago White Sox. Whoa. Kids, calm down. Find the right. It's the moment of cringe you want to hover over Bobby.
Anytime I touch the space bar, something's just going to go quick.
He pitched most notably for the Chicago White Sox and also for the Yankees, the Guardians, and the Angels. You, I guess, Kev, just don't know Jack.
Shut up, bitch. Shut up, bitch.
Welcome back, Chris.
Hey, yo.
Yep. Glad you could just leave my segment like that. You stupid.
I got you. I'll go back.
Got me. Mm-hmm. Go back. Well, you don't have to go too far back because we're done. Actually, lastly, the moment. Oh, yep. Mm-hmm. There it is.
To get that dick, I was 16 years old.
Fuck yeah. Take your time getting into it, you know?
Honey, come. That's it for this week, folks. If I missed anything, you know what to do. Just slip into my DMs at hippos814 on Instagram. Thank you, Mayor Adamson, for the supplemental research. And until next week, peace.
Whoa, I didn't hate that. Totally.
Yeah, the clip of you saying he likes to get that dick, I was 16 years old, is an actual thing you said on the podcast last week. I want you to know that, Chris.
Did Chris say that?
That was not cut up.
Wow.
I believe that I would love
to know the context of what that was about.
Maybe the whole thing was around, my beer story is when I was 16 years old. And then Kevin takes sick of the
and
dick.
I was like, yeah, he wants to get that dick. That makes sense.
Damn, Chris.
There you have it.
Man.
Well.
What's up, Daddy? What's up, Daddy?
This is the part when Kevin gets hold of all the buttons.
Oh, man. Hey, well done, Jose. As usual, no fucking...
Perfect. From start to finish, it was perfect.
Always
no
great.
Flaws Thank in you. That. Awesome. One of the things that we got going on next is... And a segment that we like to call Fill in the Blank, which is pretty fucking self-explanatory. So here we go.
It's time for Fill in the Blank. Three blanks. One answer. Two guys. Wait, one answer? There's two of us. Why is there only one answer? Who's answering? I don't get it. Ah, fuck it.
Right
fuck
back.
It indeed, Chase. Fuck it indeed. Number one question, fill in the blank. The food dish I was excited to try that disappointed me is blank, and I will go with Chris to start. Chris.
This one's very specific. I was thinking about
I love
the
that.
30 seconds. It's at Old Town. It was the open face roast beef sandwich.
I love that sandwich.
But like looking at it, I was like
disappointed in it?
Yeah, when I tried it, I was like, it was just
I love that
it was
sandwich.
Okay. It looked the presentation was outstanding. I was like, that sandwich is gonna slap. And then I had it and was like, it's all right. It was
bro, nice. I would put my mashed potatoes special. On that fucking sandwich. Great.
Mm-hmm. It was okay. It the hype did not live up for me personally.
Chase, what was the food dish that you were excited to try that disappointed you?
Yeah, I mean, you know me. I like to try like weird, unique things or what? Things that are like regions are known for.
News to me.
So, you know, years back, I did go to Paris and I tried foie gras because I felt like you had
Bless
to.
You.
It's just not. I mean, it's. It wasn't bad, but like it's just I don't. Why is this a thing?
For all of us,
why are we doing this?
Do you mind,
for all of us poor people, can you tell us what that is?
What is frog
what
ball?
The fuck is that?
So, I don't know the exact thing, but I do know that it's like it's not humane what they do, and I don't know if I knew that at the time, but
damn Chase,
wow,
we're gonna have to
yeah,
hype this
I mean
in. How do you
it's
spell
it's a very messed up way of it making it's a ball. It's a messed up way
deep
of making
fried.
Food.
Orphans. What?
No.
Jesus
Christ,
Chase.
Chase.
That was weird that Chase? We said that at the same time.
But regardless, it's not even, it wasn't even good. So
this.
I don't, why is this a thing?
Don't spell it out loud. Whatever you do, do not spell it out loud.
F-O-I-E-G-R-A-S.
Oh, nice, dude. Way to waste our time with the spelling.
Yeah, it's just, it's not good. And it's not, from what I've since learned, not really humane. So I don't, why are we like doing this? It's just not good.
I agree. That sounds stupid. Mine is empanadas. I thought they were going to be great. They're just fucking bad.
Wow.
They're fucking
you
average. Like it's just
you
like
you got some bad empanadas.
No, I got some, I've had all the empanadas at this
just
point.
Just got all of them actually.
Like it's not like I stopped at one empanada and was like, "Oh, that's the fucking shitty one." No, I've tried like empanadas forever. I was like so excited. It sounded like such a great thing. They're just fucking like pastry with meat or something in it, you know. It's like
I mean that is what it is.
Yeah, and it's not
yeah
crazy. It's like I thought it was gonna
Who
be great.
It was crazy.
I thought it was gonna be great. Empanadas is a very fucking specific like great
it's
food
yeah.
in the culture of whatever.
They're delicious. Yes.
Well, they're
Kev, he's gonna
average.
Fight you on this. So you better, he's gonna fight you on them.
Do you put any sort of sauce on them?
See
there's,
now, if you
some no, there's some
so,
great sauces that
okay,
go with
empanadas.
Okay,
so if something requires some great sauce to make
it
great, then it's gonna be trash. So, empanadas below average. Sorry, all of my Mexicano friends.
Jesus Christ! I just googled foie gras.
Yeah.
This shit's fucking awful, Chase.
It is awful.
God damn.
Yeah,
Chase, you're killing babies.
But you hear it in movies,
Chase.
And you're like, oh, I'm gonna try that.
Did you kill a literal baby?
No.
Chase, come clean right now.
Yeah, just say it.
Tell the truth.
The you're not going to get canceled, right. Chase. It's
no,
okay.
I don't know. I don't remember exactly what
know.
It is.
You didn't yeah. know. It is, it's
don't
duck
go into
liver.
Great detail. Just
it's duck liver.
But they like
history,
do something to the ducks,
history,
right?
Yes.
Isn't that what it
the,
is?
In order yeah. to be able to get it, they force feed the ducks.
Beautiful.
Yeah, I think like it's illegal in the
products.
U.S.
Which it is, which damages
yeah.
the livers
yeah.
so badly that it induces a painful disease called hepatic lipidosis.
Yeah, it's fucked
and
up.
Then yeah, it's fucked up. It's fucked yeah. up, Chase.
Hey,
I know. Well,
I got ducks
I've,
everywhere
I,
in my neighborhood.
To be
You're
fair,
okay,
I've never had it since. So
is that
you
what
you haven't
saying?
Had it since because you didn't like it? Nothing to do with the fucking reason that it's done. Okay.
But I would, if I knew what it was, I would.
If it was
it.
Fucking amazing, you'd be like, I mean,
no,
wait,
I would not.
Sorry about it.
Would,
Mary, sorry about
you're
it.
You're so full of shit. Jose,
special.
Jose, hit us with your food dish that you were excited to try, but you were disappointed.
The McRib. Everyone makes a bit made a big deal about it. And
never had one.
I
in my
never
life.
Had it, so I couldn't tell you.
I was like,
it,
all
it
right.
is so below average.
It's so below average. It is so below average. It doesn't taste like ribs. Shocking.
Shocker.
It tastes like a sketchy meat substance with bad barbecue sauce. On
it's it.
It
tastes like barbecue day in middle school. It's what it tastes like. It was really disappointing. I was hoping for something more. But there you have it.
There you got it. Number two, fill in the blank. If I could star in the remake of one movie, it would be blank. And the character I would play is blank. Jose, let's go back to you.
I would
talk in the mic so we can hear you.
I would remake I Love You Man. And ooh. I would play Sydney. Because I feel like the Sydney character could be elevated just a little bit more if it was lovable Hispanic man.
I don't see why this can't be remade, by the way.
Right? That's like, why not? I think,
let's
you know,
make it happen.
And a gay friend. Everybody loves the gay friend, right?
Not so, everybody. Like, I don't like my gay friends.
Cool.
Oh, calm down. I quickly chimed in.
I like you.
I've played bass guitar once before.
Okay, Jobin.
So there you go.
Is this your opportunity just to flex your musical skills? Or?
Yes. No,
kind of where we're going.
I think I would do a good job in that role, bringing a little Jose flair into it. I think I can elevate it.
Nope.
Nothing against
Eric Siegel.
Second name. Jason Siegel.
Jason. I said
Eric.
Oh,
Siegel.
Eric. I'm thinking of his character.
The fuck is Eric?
Which was a great character, by the way.
Yep. Great show with a laugh track too.
One of the greatest shows of all time.
Oh, and his name's not even Eric in that. It's Marshall. I don't know what I'm thinking of, Chase. I'm just making up names.
Chase, while you're making up names, why don't you hit us with that?
Yeah, man. If I get to be anything, I'm going to be an action star, obviously. I'm going to be James Bond. And as much as I want to pretend like I could be like James Bond in like Casino Royale, where it's like jumping over fucking buildings and shit. we'd have to have too many stunt doubles for that. So I'm going to go with like
nothing like you.
Yeah. So I'm going to go with like
great with you in your current form. Like that would make it funnier. Bro,
they're like, I never thought James Bond could be a comedy, but I'm seeing it now. So I'm going to go with one of the old school James Bonds where like he's just like a drunk that like doesn't really fight
like,
that well.
Fucks women.
He honestly, it almost seems like he just like gets lucky a majority of the time. And I'll go with From Russia with Love. So
now you seem like a guy that's seen like all the James Bonds.
That was a thing that my dad and I, we would rent a new James Bond movie every Friday. It was a tradition, and we've seen them all in theaters together. So yes.
So you caught up to date. You've seen them all.
Yes, I've seen them all.
That is a lot of movies.
Up to date as well? Like up to this
like
date?
With yes, the newest ones? Okay.
I have.
Which one's your favorite? Don't say the fucking old one.
It's
Sean
Connery.
Yeah.
It's Sean Connery, then Daniel Craig, then probably Pierce Brosnan,
no,
then
I mean,
Roger
movie
Moore,
was the best.
Timothy Dalton. From Russia with Love is my favorite. Fucking it's old, the first one I saw that man. I was like, fuck yes, I love this. Then it would probably be Casino Royale.
Casino Royale was so fun, man.
It was great. It was a really fun movie, and I like how they like made it where it was like he's the opening of the movie. Spoiler alert if you haven't seen it, it's like 20 years old.
You don't have to say that.
Spoiler alert.
The opening scene is he hasn't even reached 00 status yet. So like I thought that was kind of cool where it's like a completely new beginning. Because all other James Bond movies up to that point were like he is James Bond.
It's time for Phil.
The space bar. The space bar.
A man got a hold of the space bar again.
The
space bar.
Yeah. So, new beginning.
It's those fat thumbs.
I thought that was him basically being like, I just chased
I thought he was playing me off. Like, the
he's like,
not,
he's like
no, no,
Chase,
he
please.
Was not
please
just adjusting
up
my extremely sensitive keyboard, which I love and adore, but at the same time, get the fuck out of my way. No, it's a new storyline, a new beginning.
I thought that was a good take. When you're twenty movies into a run, you got to get creative with the character. So I thought that was cool.
Fair.
Chris, if I could star in a remake of one movie, it would be... Come on, Chris.
What do you think I'm going to say? I want to hear your guess.
Fast and Furious.
You have the smile.
It's
got to be Fast and Furious.
I got family. I mean, it would be entertaining when they do Fast 20 and then you could have Vin Diesel at like 70 years old rolling in here. Hey, we still got family. I'm not actually going to be in Fast and Furious.
Sure.
No, I'd never be Fast and Furious.
Sure.
I could go superhero. I could go Leo. I think I'd go Wolf of Wall Street because that would probably be a fucking blast to make that.
How
movie.
Are you going
to
redo a movie that's perfect though? Like, come on, man.
Because now it's because
eventually they're going to remake it at some point because they remake everything.
They're not going to remake that. No shot.
Never say never.
That's true.
Never.
Wasn't that a James Bond movie? So never say never.
What character would you be in that? Would you be Leo's character?
Oh, you had. Yeah, it'd have to be. Who else? I mean, I guess you play as Beth. No, you definitely have to be Jordan Belfort.
Jordan Belfort. For me, obviously, I'm gonna be Top Gun. I would star in a remake of one movie. In Top Gun Maverick, I could have been Rooster. I think it would have been. I would have been a great.
Been a good
older
like, experienced rooster,
more experienced rooster, better looking, obviously, better six pack. Man, I gotta tell you, being Top Gun Day, hashtag Top Gun Day, 38 years ago, the greatest movie alive was created. Top Gun was created 38 years ago today on May 13th. Man, what a great movie. I was watching it, Top Gun Maverick today, and just seeing how they just fit everything perfectly in like from the old movies to bring it in all together into the new movie.
What do you think? They talk about making a third one. What do you think about a third one?
Well, look, if you can hit it out of the park with Top Gun Maverick, I trust.
You have faith going in Tom Cruise?
Going into Top Gun Maverick, I was very skeptical as the biggest Top Gun fan of all time.
I give you that.
I was very skeptical, very little bit upset, be honest. Like, I was not happy about it. Like, why ruin such a great thing? They didn't make Top Gun.
At least it wasn't a remake.
Yeah,
I think that would have been terrible.
But as you moved closer to the movie being released, and they started talking about how much Maverick was involved, or Tom Cruise, excuse me, was involved in it, and how he brought
this
everything
man loves
on,
him.
And how he did everything the right way, and then wanted it. He could have released it straight to fucking streaming platform, but wanted it to be seen in the big screen.
That's how it was
the
meant
way
to be
it
seen.
Should have been yeah, seen. Man. If you didn't see it in movie theaters, I am so fucking sorry for you.
I watched it on an airplane with free Delta headphones.
That is the opposite
the
right way.
That's the opposite of how you should have watched.
That's the opposite of way how it should have been viewed. To see it like in an IMAX theater with fucking surround sound is the way that movie should be seen. And brother, he hit it out of the fucking park. So if they can do that again, and I thought that the character setup for moving forward was beautiful. It was good. I mean, you got fucking Rooster, and you got the other characters, which I don't remember their names at the time, but it's got a chance to be good. Yes, no Iceman. Thank you, Chase. You're trying to make me cry.
You didn't say spoiler alert on that one, but you said spoiler alert for the movie 40 years old.
Yeah, that is valid, Chase. The more recent one.
I mean, he's
a really
old.
Big spoiler, too.
Yeah, that's a... Damn. Sorry
it's
if you
really
haven't seen
not,
Top Gun,
it's
too.
It's really yeah. not a big spoiler
don't
at all.
Now. Sorry. But yeah, don't watch it at this point. Chase just ruined it.
Yeah, well, if you are going to watch it, please make sure you're doing it on an airplane with airline headphones.
Yeah, definitely
headphones
don't.
That anything loud happens is like crackles in your ear. Like.
Yes. Not just headphones, the free ones.
The free ones.
Look, honestly, he saw it the most authentic way on an airplane.
I was in the air. No, did you watch it in the air? You must not be a real fan.
Yeah, that's fine. I was high, but does that count? I'm just kidding.
I don't believe you.
I don't think anybody.
You have a chance to win $1 million. Guys have a chance to win $1 million. Get excited, but you have to beat The Rock in a competition. The competition you are picking is what, Jose? What is the competition?
So when I said I'm not prepared at all for any of these.
Okay, Chase, what is the competition?
The one that I struggled with. And so I decided to text my partner. And I was like, hey, what's something I'm good at? that I could, like,
oh boy,
trying to figure out, like,
oh
how
boy,
I could,
here we go,
beat their
oh
rock.
Boy.
And I was like, he's like, I don't know. And I was like, really? Like, you're like, I don't know, anything. You could say anything. Sex. And he's like, The Rock? You really think that you're better than The Rock?
You can't fuck better than The Rock. No shot.
Yeah, no way.
So there's that. Probably, I was trying to think of, like,
did he ever give
that...
you an answer?
No, he couldn't think of anything.
It's like, I got
I'm
nothing.
Good at nothing, apparently.
True love, I was going
to
say.
I was trying to think of something that The Rock would not do. Because, like,
that's
I like
how you have to, yeah.
I like to, that's how it works, right? Yeah. I like to cook, but I feel like he would probably be good at cooking.
100%.
Yeah. Seen his cheat meals.
So I'm just like, I don't know. What's something that he would absolutely, like, never not have an issue, like,
acting.
That would have an issue with? I don't know, like being poor, you know, having to do your own laundry.
Being poor, is that what you said?
Yes.
Being poor would be a good one.
Yes. Least recognizable person. Is the competition I would choose.
Walk down a road and get recognized.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, is that your answer?
Yes.
Hold on. You gave us four answers. Okay. Chris, you have an answer.
I have two. I think taking shots, obviously, I think I'd do more of The Rock. He does
no
like
shot.
Tequila.
He's going to win that.
No.
He
literally
that.
Owns a tequila. There's no
there's
fucking shot.
No shot in the world. 0%
chance.
No shot.
It's really cute. You're that confident.
Yeah,
in your
you're fucking,
abilities, Chris.
You're cute with your little vodka. You're fucking.
Just like when I
like
told
tequila.
My boyfriend that I was good at sex, and he's like, The Rock?
Yeah.
This is the equivalent of that.
The Rock okay. would shots. Fucking. Drop kick your fucking shot taking ability.
Yeah,
I'd like. I kind of want to see him do that. And then the next one, I think
he
would
rock bottom it.
You just want to talk about bottoms.
Yes, oh, I do. It's true.
What was the other
and
thing, Chris?
The other one I was gonna say. I mean, I know he does cardio, but I think a 5K that'd be an interesting one.
Yeah,
anything.
I think probably, you could beat him at 5K.
I think a 5K. Like, I mean, he does cardio, but I don't know how much running he does though.
A lot of the bigger guys' cardio is a little slept on.
I think he does do cardio, but if you approached him today and was like, "Hey, we have to do a 5K today," boom, I think you could beat him. You could beat him.
I'm surprised you didn't go with what we all know you're good at, which is like who can eat the least amount of food possible.
Who could eat the least amount? Yeah,
sucking dick. Or sucking dick. Uh-huh. I
thought that was gonna be yours.
I mean,
I don't know what The Rock does in his bedroom. I don't know.
I saw his wife for the first time yesterday.
Oh, like at
the
grocery store or something.
What? No, like on social media.
I don't know what she looks like.
He was like, it was the Mother's Day Instagram post, and he was like singing songs with her. It's so fucking cute, and she was cute too. She wasn't like. Blow your mind gorgeous, but you know she was pretty, so you know, good for him.
I didn't even know he was married.
Yeah, and I think that's a good thing.
She's all right.
Yeah,
she's all right. She's
it's a good thing. Chase, what is your thing you're gonna beat the shit out of The Rock doing?
Beat the shit out of I feel like there's two schools of thought to this. You can try and beat him at something, not knowing if he's good at it or not, and just assuming, or you can just do a game of like chance, like war. Where it's not necessarily skill based, but Mafia. I'm not gonna take the cop out. I'm not gonna take the cop out. I think with his size, shooting a little ping pong ball is gonna be and strength is gonna be hard. I feel like he's not
shooting?
Gonna be good. Yep. So beer
he's
pong.
He's gonna be bad at ping pong.
I think it's gonna be good. He's gonna be bad at beer pong because I think his hands are gotta be so fucking huge, right? That ball is gonna be so tiny in his hands. I feel like he's just gonna overshoot or overcompensate and undershoot on all the shots.
I don't know. He's been involved in a lot of things that require good timing. Like he played football.
Good timing. This isn't baseball. You're throwing the ball.
Play baseball.
At a cup. Yeah, but this isn't baseball.
Yeah. But I mean, you know, it's
so you
all
think
about
you're gonna beat The Rock in beer pong? Is that what you're saying?
I think that's one of my better shots.
All right, folks. Well, let's welcome
in
The Rock.
Yeah, let's get The Rock on here.
No, I'm just kidding.
That would be fucking great.
That would be awesome.
No. I would love to play The Rock in beer pong. That'd be great.
I thought
you were going to say flip cup, actually, Chase.
That's a good one, too. That's a good answer.
That's what
Chase
I would
losing
expect.
His house, also losing his internet.
Internet's going down with the house.
Everything. It's already in the pod.
He put the internet in the pod, which is ready to go. Not the
That's
podcast.
That's a good answer, Chris. That
the actual
good.
Pod. I was going to say drinking beers out of a dick. I feel like that I could like pour one in there, chug it before he even fucking figured out.
He's not even going to know how to pour it in.
He'd be like, God damn it.
He'd overflow it. He'd go everywhere. He'd get frustrated and then crush this tiny dick. He would be like, Kevin, is this the actual size of your dick? And I'd be like, yes, it is.
Yes. Rock,
fucking drink the beer out of my dick. And he'd be like,
Kevin's like,
why is your dick
me?
So tiny? And I'd be like, don't act like you're as bigger testosterone, motherfucker. Like, you know?
And then he'd beat the shit out of you.
And then he'd try to fight me. And then I'd be like, hey, dude, my wife's hotter than your wife. No, no, I wouldn't say that. I'm a nice guy. But yeah. So drinking,
you went down
drinking beer out of the dick is what I'm gonna do.
No,
so yeah, folks, thank you so much for joining us for fucking fill in the blank.
She's like, what segment are we on?
And then you know, we got one final segment that is going to end your night
life.
I thought he was gonna say life. I was like, damn.
Damn, and this is what it is. Listening.
Oh, happy birthday, Chase. Oh, happy birthday, yeah. Oh, from the Cup to Cup show. I'm the Island Boys. We want to make you a third Island Boy. Yeah. You with that third Island Boy. Oh, Chase, you live it up. Oh, happy birthday,
up,
yeah. Oh, for your birthday, yeah, yeah. Oh, girl, beat that race. Oh, Chase, you got that cool name.
Cool name?
It's a, little early, it's a little early birthday
show. Where have you
Chase.
Gone, Island Boys? They are gone. They're gone.
They are posting their dicks on Twitter. That's what they're doing.
And
is that confirmed? Sure, you've seen their dicks on Twitter?
I may have stumbled upon it. I wasn't excited about it.
You know what, young lady? Do you want to go to timeout? All right. One, two, three. It's time for dad tips.
Dad tip. I don't got really nothing too much to talk about what happened this week. I got super frustrated. I wanted everything to go perfect for Mother's Day, so I was like, gave them like a preview. I was just like, look, you girls have to be on your best behavior all day long. This is not your day, you know. No complaining, no bitching and complaining, no fucking going crazy, you know. Like, whatever mommy wants to do, this is what we're going to do. Mommy wanted to just be lazy. She wanted to fucking, she literally just wanted to sit around the house and not do anything. She wanted to watch her Hallmark shows and just, and I'm I don't agree. I don't disagree with her. You know, she's going 24 hours a day, 7 days a week with these girls. So to have one day by herself just to chill and relax. So the girls hated it. They kept on bothering her, and it got me fucking so heated. The point where I had to fucking calm myself down. I was just like, at this point, I think this silence is the best thing. So I just like was just trying not to go off on the kids, and I was just trying to just stay quiet. And I could have. It took a lot for me not to just be like, we fucking talked about this like all day long. Like, and I even outside of when we were away from Erica during Mother's Day, I was just like, what are we doing? Like, we've talked about this. Like, we have already spoken about what we're supposed to be doing today. And you guys are like going up to mommy and being like, oh, I'm so bored. What are we doing today? Like, we should be doing something, you know? Like, it took everything in my mind not to go crazy. But I ended up realizing that my silence made things awkward for her and made things fucking, you know, not right with her, which ended up, she will never admit it, but I think it ended up making it worse for the day. So I should have taken my own advice. You know, when I'm telling the kids to, hey, don't do this, don't do that during Mother's Day, you know, I need to suck it up that day and not have a fucking pity party and be like, you're just going to go in silent treatment and just fucking not do anything, you know, when I should have been like, look, let's leave mommy alone, you know, and talking out, okay, girls, you know, instead of talking it out. I should have did something different. So I think it's okay to make mistakes as a father, is what I'm trying to say. And
recognize the mistakes.
Recognize them and learn from your mistakes.
For sure.
Next year, you know, we'll be on our tippy toes. We'll have plans in place. Because my plan in place for Mother's Day was just like, whatever you want to do, let's do it. And I did not expect nothing. So
I'm not due.
Next year I will have nothing in the plans just in case.
that will be the backup plan of nothing.
So I have something for the girls if she just wants to chill at home and do nothing. But she went and got her nails done and got a pedicure, manicure. Yeah. But that was my mistake, and I learned from my mistakes. So I'm just saying it's okay to make mistakes as a dad, as a dude, as a father, as a parent, as a person. As long as you just learn from them and move forward, you know.
And that's a good wrap up of your point. I like that.
Thank you.
This one guy that gives dad tips one time gave a dad tip about, you know, sometimes things aren't going to go the way they're planned, and that's okay. So just go with it. And so
that sounds like a smart guy. Whoever said that.
Sounds like a smart guy. Whoever said
pretty
that.
Smart. I don't know him. I don't know him, but he sounds like a smart guy.
Hey, the one dude that would say that on this podcast is an idiot. So that's not
dumbass.
No, but yeah. I mean, look, Mother's Day, you know, and I kept on asking her because she was in such relaxed mode, which she's usually. High intensity, you know. I'm like, you all right? What's going on? Like, you know. And she's like, I'm fine. You know, I'm chilling. Like, everything's cool. You know. Mm-hmm. And I feel like at some point, like I was just like, me asking her constantly, "Are you okay? Are you? What's going on?"
It made her not okay.
She's
it's like
fine.
A self-fulfilling prophecy.
Yeah, it's like I was okay, but now I'm like,
but now that you've asked me,
should I not
times?
Be okay? Yeah.
Not okay. Nothing is okay.
So, ask me one more time, and I'm not gonna be okay.
it kind of fucked me up for that night. I wasn't really in a good place, to be honest. I was, but you know, here we are. Next day, I apologize and to both my wife and my kids. You know, so I think that's important too. Is to if you realize you're wrong, to notice it and recognize it. You know,
and learn from it.
Yeah,
like you said, learn from it.
Yeah, yeah. So there you go.
There you go, Bubs.
Good job.
There you go, Bubs.
Guys, got anything else to say? We've been fucking recording for 3 hours.
Ooh, 3 hours, baby. We passed that 3 hour threshold.
3 hour threshold.
The only thing I got.
Fucking Dustin's arm would have fallen off at this point.
Dustin's arm would be sitting there
just shaking.
Dustin, I don't know what we're doing here, but apparently you like being held hostage because you're coming back on the emoji game. So, you know.
Don't, Dust.
If you want to be on the podcast, first of all, go listen to that Dustin episode. You're going to regret that. Because you get held hostage.
Yep, and it's not your choice. Kevin will message you. You will get bullied. You want to be on the podcast? Great, we'll see you on Monday.
Yeah. But right now,
can I think about it? Nope, you're coming on.
All
right. Right now, we have Rob in first at 11, Dustin and Mike tied for second at 8, and then we got Bill at 5, JC at 3, Naomi, Kayla, Dennis, and Emily at 1.
Well, so that's I'd love to have Dustin on again. Don't get me wrong.
I would as well.
I would also love to have Rob or Mike on. I think that'd be awesome.
I'd love to have any of those people on.
Yeah. I mean, all of our boys are all good people. So, you know, I'd love to have.
For sure.
You know what would also be fun is to actually have a fucking guest on here that's not winning contests. And so if you guys got any ideas on guests that possibly any cool person that you know. You know, it doesn't even fucking matter at this point.
Or if you have a cool brewery near you and you want to get another What's on Tap episode going,
bro, I've been slinging cards everywhere.
Yep. Or if you got a cool bracket idea, or if you just want to run the podcast for us,
take over the podcast.
Our fearless leader has left us. He's gone forever.
And look, we need a leader, guys.
All right, Jason, you can come back now. How about you come back next week?
Also, the we need a leader was just kind of a shot at me. I just want to throw it out there. I don't appreciate that.
Because, like, I'm living.
Look, I feel like you've stepped up and done a more than admirable job.
Do you see these bags under my eyes?
Stays up all
podcast.
Night.
No, it's just because I'm sleepy. It has nothing to do with the podcast.
Just fucking tired.
Yeah, I'm just tired. No, I'm just kidding. Love you guys so much. Thank you. Episode 252. Good night. And go check out Cup to Cup show on all social sites.
I was like, should I do it? I'm like,
he's tired, man. He just said he's tired.
DCTC OnlyFans. DCTC OnlyFans. Go join that on Facebook, which is Chase's favorite website on his phone, Facebook.com.
Every Tuesday, Thursday.
Also, check out our merchandise store where you can get my hat, Chris's hoodie, Jose's shirt, Chase's shirt, anything Cup to Cup related. We're going to have to come out with some new shirt ideas here soon. I've been thinking about that. It's about time for me and Chris's drunk night where we come up with shirt ideas.
He's going to get hammered, be like, come on, let's figure them out.
Good ones, Pod Poppy.
Pod Poppy sounds great.
Pod Daddy is another one.
I don't know how many people are going to wear that out and about.
You will.
Look, there's shirts, and then there's shirts like, hey, come on my fucking face. I'm not going to wear that out in public, you know? Like,
well, that's a you thing.
That's true, yes.
Pod Daddy? That'll sell.
Like, go outside, and you're wearing a shirt. It's like, is that cum on my face? Like, are you looking?
Are you just happy to see
Stop
me?
Staring at the cum on my face or something like that? Yeah, like,
does that shirt just say normal on it? Yes, actually, it does. And you can get that's it at the Cup store.
Yeah. I did get two or three comments on my dad, girl dad shirt when I was in Jacksonville. Nice. One girl was like, oh, that's like a, you know, what did she say? A Saved by the Bell theme. I like that, you know, that's because it was kind of like a retro looking one.
Yeah, yeah.
When so. I wake up in the morning. That's all I remember from
now. He knows everything about it.
Yeah,
Chris, I still don't know anything.
Yeah, Chris has never seen the show. Chris, have you ever seen it?
Have you really never seen the show?
I've seen it. I just, if you were like,
Chris, have you ever watched a full episode of Saved by the Bell?
You can skip the college years, but
I've watched a full
episode. I just
don't know any of their names.
Lisa was to die for in there, along with the rest of the
girls. Lisa Turtle?
Yeah, Lisa Turtle took a change in college years.
Did she? It's been a while.
I was like, wait a second, Lisa.
Man, college years were not good to her.
No, they were good to her.
They were. Excuse me. Yeah. I don't know. Fuck it.
Anyways, we're gonna Tiffany go Amber Thiessen also
in his
has
voice
another hour of Cup to Cup this week.
Tiffany Amber Thiessen has not aged as well. She is still gorgeous. My wife is like, oh, she's selling this stuff or whatever, doing this stuff on, you know, whatever social site. And I'm just like, yes, she is.
Yes, she is. What's that? All right. Damn. I've subscribed. Whatever.
But anyways, love you guys so much. Holler.
Bye.
Hater, skeezer, skank, scallywags.
Skinks and scallywags.
Oh, he's gone.
There you go. He said, later, skeezer.
Okay. Didn't even stop
we're still
recording.
Recording, so.
I'll stop it.
Okay, great. All right. Bye.
Later, skeezers.
Later, bye, skeezers.